Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. I welcome all the students of engineering, especially the students of Khwaja Fareed University, Rahim Jar Khan. Dear students, we have covered the kinematics of body, and we have discussed the rectilinear motion, curvilinear motion, curvilinear motion in, of course, in Cartesian coordinates, in anti-coordinates, normal tangential and r theta coordinates, and also the 3D motion, spherical coordinates. Now, what we are talking of today, and this is chapter number 3 of J.L. Mariam, that is kinetics. As we have discussed earlier, in kinetics, we are not only studying the effect of the forces, but we also study the cause which produce that particular motion, that is position, velocity and acceleration. It means now the force is also be considered, what forces, what causes, what source which is producing that particular motion, that is position, velocity and acceleration. So the basic formulae that we have derived for anti-coordinates, Cartesian coordinates and also for r-theta coordinates and cylindrical coordinates, these are the same. Only the Newton's second law of motion is being applied here for the, of course, the linear motion or the curvilinear motion depending upon the motion time. So let's start this chapter number 3, kinetics of a particle. So kinetics of a particle means to study the effect of forces with the reference to the cause which produces, and that the cause in this case is basically the force. Just for revision, of course, the three things are related according to with Newton's second law of motion is a mass, acceleration, to force. And you know that force is directly proportional to acceleration according to Newton's second law of motion, or F is equal to ma, with F is the force, m is the mass and a is the acceleration. If I'm talking of in SI units, of course, the unit of mass is kilogram. And of course, we have 1 kilogram of mass. This mass, if in the vertical free fall, have a force or a weight of 9.81 newtons, and the acceleration constant is, that is gravitational, that is acceleration due to gravity, which is 9.81 meter per second square. If you are going to US customary, that is basically the FPS system, they are talking of mass is a pound mass. 1 pound mass is, of course, 1 over 32.2 slug, with W is equal to mg. So the m is equal to W by g, and g is 32.2 feet per second square in case of US customary or the FPS system. And the weight, of course, is a 1 pound force. Remember that we write the pound for both, one for mass and one for pound force. Remember that 1 pound mass is basically 1 over 32.2 slug. That actually the slug is the unit of mass in FPS system. And acceleration is, of course, actually due to gravity, is 2.2 feet per second square. So that is the gravitational free fall. If I'm talking of the linear motion, if I'm talking of in the SI system, F is equal to ma, we have a 1 newton of force. If a body of 1 kilogram is accelerating with 1 meter per second square, we say the force acting on a body is 1 newton. Similarly, in the case of FPS system, if 1 pound force is being applied on a mass of 1 pound mass, which is 1 over 32.2 slug, it is accelerating with an acceleration of 32.2 feet per second square, we say the force acting on a body is a 1 pound force. So, student, that has been clear. Next, the important thing is types of dynamic problems. There are two types of dynamic problems. In the first type of dynamic problems, that acceleration of the particle is given to us, and we will find the force acting on a body. The other type of problems, in the forces are acting on a particle are specified, and we must determine the resulting motion if the forces are constant. And resulting motion means we have to find out the position, velocity and acceleration. We know the forces and we will find the position, velocity and acceleration. In the second case, in the first case, if we have the acceleration, we are trying to find the forces. As far as the type of motion is concerned, constrained and unconstrained motion, there are two physically distinct types of motions, both described by Newton's second law, of course. That is, the first type is unconstrained motion, where the particle is free of mechanical guides. It means the body is not to be forced to move along the path, like the train, like the things moving in a rail, right? That is not the case. and it follows the path determined by its initial motion and by the forces which are applied to it from the external forces, like an aeroplane or rocket in flight, like a motion of a car and an electron moving in a charged field. These are the examples of the unconstrained motion. The second type is the constrained motion, where the path of the particle is particularly or totally determined by the restraining guides. An ice hockey puck is particularly constrained to move in a horizontal plane by the surface of the ice. Similarly, a train moving along its track and a collar slides along a fixed shaft are examples of a more fully constrained motion. Some of the forces acting on a particle during constrained motion may be applied from outside sources, and other may be the reaction of the particle from the constraining guides. Mostly the forces are acting outside, and the body forces are basically the reactive forces. All forces, both applied and reactive, which act on the particle must be accounted for in applying Newton's second law of motion. So in a constrained motion, the body is constrained either through ropes, either through rails, either that's like a collar moving in this, like a piston is moving in a cylinder. This is a constrained motion. It cannot move here and there. It can only move in the path which is being followed. But in the case of the unconstrained motion, it is not mechanically constrained, right? And it can move in any direction, like rocket, plane, car, human beings. Movement is basically unconstrained. And constrained motion that we have already studied in the previous chapters, that is motion of the connected bodies. So let's talk of first of all the motion along the rectilinear motion. Rectilinear motion is a motion along a straight line. You also know that in the Cartesian coordinate, we write summation of fx is equal to max, summation of fy is equal to my, and summation of f of z is equal to maz. The acceleration, of course, has a vector quantity is axi plus ayj plus azk, and we need to find the magnitude. Of course, ax square plus ay square plus az square is under the square root. Similarly, force has an x component, y component, z component, and of course, magnitude, the summation of fx square plus fy square plus fz square under root, you get the magnitude of the force. Let students start trying to solve the sample problem. Sample problem 3-1, a 75 kilogram man stands on a spring scale in an elevator. During the first 3 seconds of motion from rest, the tension in the hoisting cable is 8300 Newton. Find the resulting reaction R, right? What is the net resulted reaction on the body, that is R, okay, of the scale in Newtons during the interval, and the upward velocity V of the elevator at the end of the 3 seconds. The total mass of the elevator man and scale is 750 kilogram. Man is 75 kilogram, and other elevator and other thing is total weight is 750 kilogram. The man is standing on the weighing scale, and this elevator is moving upward with some velocity which is given to you, and let's need to find what is the reaction forces on this. So as the elevator is moving in the upward direction, so summation of y is equal to may, mass we are given. So we will talk of the motion, and the force, that is which force is larger, of course this tension force, this is the tension, because body moving in the upward direction, so acceleration in the upward direction, this force is larger than the weight. So T minus MD is equal to MAY. So 8300 into 750 into 9.81, and we get 750 AY. From here we can find the acceleration of this elevator is 1.25 meter per second square in the upward direction. Now for reaction R. Now let's see for reaction R. This is the free body diagram. The reaction is the upward direction, and the weight in the downward is the reaction of the scale, okay, on the body. So it is R minus, of course, the mass of the person when the elevator is stationary. So 9.81 to 75 is equal to 75 in this acceleration. So R is equal to 830 Newton. It means the apparent weight of the body, which is shown by the scale, is to be increased as the elevator is moving in the upward direction. And if you need to find the velocity after this 3 seconds, so dv is equal to a is equal to dv by dt, dv is equal to a dt that we have discussed earlier in the in previous chapters very detail. So v is equal to at, right? Take the integration 0 to 3. And this is the velocity after 3 seconds, 3.771 meters per second. So, dear students, this is a classic example. Similarly, if when elevator is moving downward, of course, in that case, of course, the weight is larger than the reaction, and you will see the weight will be reduced. This is very clear. As long as you have a bucket of water, you are moving in the upward direction. Of course, the weight is to be increased. If you move in the downward direction, and it is easy to come down because the weight to be decreased. I hope this is understandable. Now the next question is 3-2. A small inspection car with a mass of 200 kg runs along the fixed overhead cable and is controlled by the attached cable at A. Determine the acceleration of the car when the control cable is horizontal and under a tension of 2.4 kN. Also find the total force P exerted by the supporting cable on the wheel. So this is the tension of the rope which is given 2.4 kilonewtons. We need to find this force P, okay, along which this crane is moving, and the slope is given to you, it's 512, this should be 13. So let's we move to the free body diagram. If you see, this is the body, and of course this is the force P which is 512, the weight in the outer direction, this is the component along the P, and this is the, of course, the perpendicular. This is the acceleration, A is also 512, this is the T. This is the free body diagram, the weight is downward from the center of gravity. So tension is 2.4 kilonewton. Summation of F of Y is equal to 0. Why it is 0? Because there is no motion along the Y direction, there is no motion across the cable. So the vertical motion is P, right, P, this is the P. Similarly, T, this component of T, which is 5 by 13, minus weight, which is W cos of theta is 12 by 13, is equal to 0. We find the force is 2.73 kilonewtons. Summation of, now it's moving in the x direction. So summation of Fx is equal to Max. Now, 2400 is 2.4 kilonewton, right? This is the force. This component of the force along this, which is 12 by 13, right? 12 by 13 is x along this. So it's 12 by 13. Minus 1962, this is the weight, right? 1962 weight component, which is along the vertical, in the opposite direction, the sine of theta, which is slope is 5 by 13, is equal to MA, mass is 200, there's A, we get the acceleration is 7.3 meter per second square. So the force of the cable is giving, that is about 2.73 kilonewtons, and acceleration is 7.3 meter per second square. So let's move to sample problem 3-3. The 250-pound concrete block A is released from rest. This A is released from rest in the position shown and pulled the 400-pound log up the 30-degree ramp. If the coefficient of kinetic friction between the log and the ramp is 0.5, determine the velocity of the block as it hit the ground at P. Now, dear students, this is the constraint problem. And you see there's only one rope that we have done these type of problems in case of kinematics, but only now the forces are also given. This block is to be released from this position and comes down by covering a distance of 20 feet. Of course, this block will move in the upward direction where the kinematic friction is 50 newton. So first of all, you will make the free body diagram. And of course, if this is the tension T, this should be T and this is also T, it becomes 2T. So I'm making the free body diagram. This is SA, this is SC, right? First of all, we find the velocities. So is L is equal to 2, if I'm not wrong, it's 2YC plus YA plus constant, right? So 0 is equal to 2VC plus VA, and 0 is equal to 2AC plus AA. These are the relationship for the velocity and the acceleration of A and B. Now motion in the Y direction. If I talk motion in the Y direction, if this is the free, this is the 2T, this is 2TT, this is again 2T, and this is the weight, this is the coefficient of friction because the frictional force downward, this is a normal reaction. So let's move to the vertical in there. If this is the Y direction, so N minus the component of the weight, that is basically the cos of theta, cos of 30, that is, we get the normal reaction. Now the motion along the x, because the motion is going on along the x, so mx is fx is equal to max. So this is the frictional force, right? Frictional force in the downward direction, 0.5 N, right? Minus this is 2t plus 400 sine of 30, that is the weight component, is equal to ma, which is 432.2, because this becomes forces in pounds, so this will be slug ac. So we get the acceleration of the c. Here the tension is unknown and acceleration c is unknown. This is equation number 2. Let's move forward. Now for block A, I'm talking of the block A, this block A. So this block A is of course 250. 250 is the weight, minus t is equal to ma, right? This is AA. Now, solving the three equations, we have three equations, right? This is one of the relationship between the accelerations. Then the second is this one for the body C, and this is for body A. Now, AC is equal to AA is equal to minus 2AC. Put this value in equation number 3, and we get the relationship between 250 minus T and AC. And we have the relationship for this equation number 4. We already have a relationship between T and AC, which is my equation number 2. Right? So by solving this 2 and 4, and we cancel the tension T, we get the AC. Once we know AC, we will find AA, which is minus 2 times of AC. And we put the value of AC in any one of the equation, we get the tension T is 250 pounds. So this is the, I hope it should be clear. Let's see the sample problem 3-4. The design model for a new ship has a mass of 10 kilogram and is tested in an experimental towing tank to determine its resistance to motion through the water at various speeds. The test results are plotted on the accompanying graph. This is the graph giving the velocity, and here is the reaction forces. And the resistance R may be closely approximated by the dashed parabolic curve shown. If the model is released when it has a speed of 2 meter per second, determine the time t required for it to reduce its speed to 1 meter per second and the corresponding travel distance x. Right? So the velocity is 2 meter per second at this instant. We need to find how much distance it will travel and the time t at which the velocity becomes 1 meter per second. So we have given, if you see, this is the relationship, very simple relationship, r, because it is a parabolic, so r is equal to kv square from the given graph. So m is equal to 10 kilogram, which is given to us, m is equal to 10 kilogram, right? Yes, we are given. So so at r is equal to 8, we can find the value of k by taking any value. If you value at r is equal to 8, v is equal to 2, from this going to relation we get the, of course, the constant k, which is 2 v square from the graph. I think this is clear. It's at 8, velocity is v. You can take any point. You can take also, for example, this is 4, or you can find this value. But it is easy to read, so therefore I took the, for example, v is 1, and then the reaction is 2. You get the same constant, there's no problem. So fx is equal to m. As ship is moving in the, of course, forward direction, and r is the resistive force. So therefore it is minus r is equal to max. So r is equal to minus 2v square is equal to max. So minus 2v square is equal to mass is 10ax. So minus 2v square is equal to 10 dv by dt. Now variable separable method. So 0 to t dt minus 5 dv by d square. So this becomes t minus 5. This minus 2. Minus 2 plus 1 over minus 1, right? 2 to v with 5, 1 by v minus 1 by 2. Upper limit minus lower limits seconds. So v is equal to... from here, we can find out the relationship between V. I just simplify, I get V is equal to half V naught. So we know the value of V naught is 2 by 2 is 1 meter per second. So what is time T taken to reach this one? This is 5, 1. Here I put the value of the velocity 1. So I get 2.5 seconds. So it takes 2.5 seconds to reduce the velocity to half of its initial velocity. Right? Similarly, I need to find the distance traveled. You know that you have a relationship T is equal to 5, 1 by V minus 1 by 2. I just take a little bit of simplification to separate the velocity in terms of T. T, V is equal to 10 by 5 plus 2T. And now V is equal to dx by dt. by variable separate method 0 to s and time is 0 to 2.5. So so this becomes s or x, and this becomes 10 by 2 ln, because this is the power of t is minus 1. So it's ln this, and we have 5 ln 5 plus 2 t 0 to 2.5. I just put the upper limit minus lower limit. I get 3.47 meters. So the ship covers 3.47 meters. And with after 2.5 seconds, its velocity becomes half of the initial velocity from 2 meter per second to 1 meter per second. Simple problem 3-5. The collar of mass M, this collar, mass M, slides up the vertical shaft under the action of force F of constant magnitude but variable direction. If theta is equal to kt, where k is the constant, and if the collar starts from rest, right, this collar starts from rest, where theta is equal to 0, theta is equal, determine the magnitude F of the force which will result in the collar coming to rest as theta reaches to theta pi by 2. The coefficient of kinetic friction between the collar and the shaft is mu k. This collar is moving up and down. The kinetic coefficient of friction is mu k, right? When this angle is 0, right, collar start, this is at rest. Now, if I make the free body diagram, of course, my weight is the downward direction, and of course, the friction is also downward direction, and this is the normal from the normal reaction from the side, and this is the resultant force which is being coming, given by this rod. So we have the two vertical forces, one horizontal force, and one force is at an angle theta. So in this free body diagram I've shown you, right? This is the weight, friction force, normal force, and this is F. It is coming downward, so, or it is moving upward, the friction force in the up, in the opposite direction. So summation of MAX, summation of Y is equal to MAY, or F cos of theta, right? This is the F cos of theta. Sorry, this is MAK, cos of theta minus mu KN, right? Minus MG is equal to M dV by dt or MA. As theta is equal to KT, so I replace F is equal to cos of KT minus mu KF sine of KT minus MG dt. And then, sorry, we have M0 to dV. And then I take the, of course, the integration with respect to T. So it becomes F of K sine KT plus, this is sine, so it becomes minus cos, and that's minus MGT is equal to MV. And similarly, F of K sine of KT plus VS and KT minus, this becomes this, and then becomes minus MGT is equal to MV. As it is equilibrium in the x direction, in the x direction is simple, F of sine theta, because F of this one, this is sine of theta minus n is equal to n, is basically F of sine theta. So this is the relationship, F of k sine kt plus mu k cos of t minus mgt is equal to mv. Now for theta is equal to pi by 2, the time becomes theta is equal to kt, t is equal to theta by k, or it becomes 2 theta is equal to 2 pi and 2k, and v is equal to 0. So I put the value, so F of k is equal to 1 plus mu k 0 minus 1. Why 0 minus 1, please? I'll show you. This is 0 minus 1. 0 minus 1, right? This cos of a 2 pi becomes 0. So it is becomes 1 mu k minus 1 upper limit minus mg pi by 2k is equal to 0. So therefore, I simplify, I've got the force, it's mg pi 2 times 1 minus mu k. Right, so theta is equal to kt, and t is equal to theta by k. As theta is equal to pi by 2, so pi 2k. Right, so I just put the values here. Of course, cos 2 pi 0, this becomes 1 upper limit minus lower limit is upper limit minus lower limit. Right, so I put the values, both of them at 0, it is 0 and minus 1. Right, so therefore, it is 0 minus 1. So this mg pi 1 minus mu k. So it's a function of the mass and the coefficient of friction. Thank you very much, the students, for this. Inshallah, in the next lecture, I will solve some of the unsolved problems related to kinetics of particle, of course, in the rectilinear motion. So be ready for the next lecture as well.